covered?
Yeah, we're good to go.
Okay.
Move.
Hey, keep your hands where I can see them! Get them from this.
He plays FBI agent Martin Fitzgerald on the popular CBS primetime drama Without a Trace. With his good looks and his acting abilities, Eric has made an impact in Hollywood, but ask about his priorities and this husband, father, and church deacon is very clear in saying, it's definitely God and family.
Was there something particular that brought you to LA?
USC. It was the only college that would even consider accepting me. So,
when did the first major job come along?
The first major job was Santa Barbara when I was doing a soap opera, and that came along in '92, and end of '91, beginning of '92, and I did that for 11 months. But there was a few jobs along the way, but that was my first job that really took me from starving actor to an actor who could eat again.
Yeah, it's interesting. The soap opera experience is interesting because I was talking to Kevin Dobson the other day, who has done a lot of stuff, Kojak and a lot of different things, and was also at one time had a big role in soaps. And he said that it probably was one of the greatest training grounds he could have had. He said, because when I do a film, if I do 3-4 pages a day, then, you know, we're doing pretty well. He said, if I do a TV series, if I do 12-13 pages a day, he said, but when I was doing a soap, I could do 100 pages a day. He said, you really had to get into it quick. And he said, you didn't have a lot of time for rehearsal. He said, you worked your lines, you did it. And he said, probably one of the greatest training grounds for young actors that he could imagine. Did you find that to be true? Was it a good experience for you?
Yeah, you know, the one thing I have learned, though, is that if you refer to soap opera work as a training ground in front of another soap opera actor, they don't like that, because it's just as legitimate of a job as any other job as an actor. You know, they work really hard. They're learning a lot of, like you said, a lot of dialogue. But I think any job that you have is training you to become a better actor, a better listener, a better performer, whether you're on stage, doing a soap, television, film. And so I understand what he's saying, but, you know, there's some people who've made a career out of working
in soap operas
and good performances, too. You know, I don't watch soap operas, but I did as a kid. You know, my grandfather, my mom's dad, who's from Hungary as well, we used to, when he would watch us, when my parents would go on a trip or something, we'd watch The Guiding Light, As the World Turns. And, you know, so I grew up on those soap operas. And one of the cool things was when I got onto Santa Barbara, the soap opera, Kim Zimmer ended up playing my mom on Santa Barbara, and she was someone that I grew up just loving to watch. So it was that was kind of a neat experience.
But was it a good, for you, was it a good experience?
Absolutely. And, you know, it was disappointing because it got canceled after 11 months. And that, the ironic thing is it sort of became the story of my life for the first 10 years of my career. You know, I went year after year from show to show that would, you know, on one hand, I consider that successful because I was on a show that would go for a season. But now finally, after, you know, 13 years, I'm on a show that's going into its fourth season. So that's pretty cool.
But all along, you're still building a body of work.
Absolutely. There's no better place to learn and to grow as an actor than working. I think acting classes is important, but there's nothing better than being in front of the camera and the lights and the crew and working with other actors.
Sure.
And,
you know. Who were some of the most interesting people that you've worked with?
First name that comes to mind is J.T. Walsh. I worked with J.T. Walsh on a show called Dark Skies that was created by Bryce Abel and Brent Friedman, and which was a brilliant show. I really enjoyed working with J.T. I mean, he was probably the most well-known character actor next to Gene Hackman at the time. And he was just fun to work with. He was very loose. You know, one of the things I admired about him, as myself being a young actor, I would always ask him, how do you stay so loose? And, you know, right before the cameras are ready to roll, he's kidding around and you know, I'm real serious and trying to get into the moment. And he told me, he says, you know what, you will find the more relaxed and loose you stay, the better your performance will be. And that I have found to be true. But the paradox about that is that you feel like it when you're being loose, you feel like you're being lazy or you're not doing your job. But when you really do your job is you do your homework and you come in prepared, then you let it go and you loosen up. It's there. So when that camera rolls, you can do it. I have a friend who's worked with Mel Gibson. He says Mel Gibson or Tom Hanks, same way. They can be right in the middle of a joke, and then they roll camera and tears start coming and they do that performance. And then back they're like, so anyway, the punchline of the joke is, and because they're professionals. You're good at what you do. It's like you watch the good golfers or any of those athletes. They're kidding around. They're trash talking each other or whatever it is. But when it comes to the moment of hitting that shot or taking that jump shot, they focus. So
everything kicks in, all of the experience, all of the knowledge.
The preparation.
All the preparation that goes into that. Do you consider yourself, Eric, a character actor?
You know, I think that's sort of always been kind of like Brad Pitt's thing, too. You know, I think every actor wants to be able to play different characters. I've always approached my career looking at, first it comes down to the story. I read the story and I say, is this a good story? Do I want to be a part of the story, even if I have two lines in the whole story?
Yeah.
If that is a good story and I can attach my name to that story and say, I can be proud to say I was part of that.
Yeah.
That's for a second, obviously, is the character. Does this character have a nice arc to it, or is he important to furthering the story along? And so, but the other part of it is I like to play different types of characters. It's probably inevitable that I will play similar roles throughout my career.
That's me. I need to ask you a few questions about Teddy Kota.
You're friends with him, right?
Kinda.
What do you mean, kinda?
He's been around here for the last 3 months or so.
Well, he's missing, and we're trying to find out where he is.
You're not, like, Men in Black?
The movie?
You mean the government alien conspiracy?
That's a theory, yeah.
Wait, what conspiracy?
Well, it's basically a pact between the gray aliens and a secret rebel faction of the government intent on destroying the human race.
Really?
Yes.
You're recognized by a lot of people. From Without a Trace, and that's been a good run for you, isn't it?
Oh, it's been fantastic. Yeah, it's been it's sort of weird because I can't believe that we're getting ready to go into a fourth season. It just seems like it just flew by.
Yeah.
And it's hard to even imagine that it was almost 4 years ago that we were shooting the pilot, and here we are. And the thing I like about Without a Trace is, for the most part, it seems to be somewhat effortless because we have found our groove, if you will. It's we found the right director of photography. We've found the right crew. We have great camera department. We have a nice writing team. The cast works well together, and so all that. And in the beginning stages of a series, you're finding out how that works. You're figuring out who the best directors are. There may be a good director, but they may not click with everybody. And so, once you get that pool of directors and everything comes together,
all of a sudden,
exactly, it's a well-oiled machine.
Yeah, it's a well-oiled machine.
Yeah, my dream always was to be a director, and. I realized that it was to be an actor as well. So I just wanted to do all that, and I've been very fortunate to be able to be a professional actor. And I knew that dream to eventually direct will always be there, and I didn't give up on that.